That is amazing. So that, because I mean, obviously, the other question, obviously, which I mean, it's entirely up to you when you talk about it, but it is difficult not to, you know. I was thinking about it on the way here. My dad worked for a building society.
Yeah.
So not a lot of people said to me, oh, it must have been amazing when you were a kid.
With your dad.
With your dad.
The building society.
Yeah, it was really exciting. I used to go to the office on a Saturday morning. You know?
It was, no, I mean, my dad was in the music industry.
Yeah.
And we travelled a lot because of his work. So we were living in many different countries as I grew up.
Right. So you did, would you go on tour with him then? I mean, that's, it's all those questions. I mean, it's, yeah, I'm not sure you've had to answer them millions of times.
Not so much. I mean, he tried his best. I mean, my parents divorced when I was very young.
And right.
I ended up, in my dad's custody and living with my dad.
Oh, right. Yeah, you did.
Which was quite unusual back then. Because normally the mother gets custody, but my dad got custody. And he tried the best he could to make sure that I was based in one place as much as possible, which ended up being Switzerland.
Right.
But then a lot of the time it wasn't possible. We'd be, for some one reason or another, we would have to be moving. So I ended up going to quite a few different schools in different places.
Right.
Lived in Berlin for a while and Switzerland, obviously, in New York. And then we were in Japan for a while, in Australia. So we were kind of all over the place.
Wow.
But it was great for me in some ways, because I think it gave me sort of a more multicultural, appreciation of the world.
Yeah. Wow, that must be it was very hard to try. You know, I grew up outside Whitney in Oxfordshire,
which is multicultural.
Multicultural in its own way.
It's got people from the north of England and the south of England.
Well, not many from the north, darling.
No, I had no interest in music. Absolutely
really?
Not.
Wow.
That was my big rebellion. I was a jock. I played loads of sports. Loved computer games.
Wow.
But music wouldn't have anything to do with it.
That is extraordinary, isn't it? Because when you think of I saw your dad in 1972 in Oxford.
Yeah.
And, you know, it was a game changer for me. I mean, but you would not classify your father as a jock.
No.
You could classify him as many different things.
But not a jock.
But not a jock. You know, of all the things it's so typical, isn't it?
Played loads of sports. I was really into it.
Right. And how did he deal with that? Was he happy about that?
He tried his best, bless him. He'd come out. I mean, I used to play things like American football and stuff, and he'd come out with his little video camera, not understanding what was going on. And,
that's such a great image.
Clap at the wrong time.
Yeah. But then I suppose, was your generation, that's what I can't imagine, is whether your generation was as aware of him as mine was. I mean, he was hugely influential on my generation because we, you know.
I'm not sure, I guess.
But I suppose that.
Maybe a little less so, but.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I'm just wondering whether, you know, like the kid, your mates.
I'd still get a good ribbing when I was growing up in school and things like that.
But, yeah.
You know, that's just. I think everyone gets that for one reason
exactly.
or another.
You do, because my dad had a handlebar moustache. He'd been in the RAF, so he had this huge...
Fantastic.
It was the tash.
Have you ever been tempted?
No. I have bearded up quite a few times, but then everyone just goes, they just go, get rid of that. Don't do that.
Oh, okay.
And I get classified as a tramp.